Today we are going to discuss the chapter of immunology and the subtopics, that is antigen and antibody immunity. In our last video we have discussed that what is immunity. Immunity is the ability of our body to fight against disease. Alright students, so today we will discuss what are antigen, what are the molecules that activates our immune system. So first of all we are going to discuss antigen. Antigen is a foreign substance that may be protein, that may be lipid, that may be cell wall of bacteria that activates the production of antibodies in our body. So antigen is specifically made up of two words, anti and gen. Anti means antibodies, gen means generating. Antibodies generating. So we can conclude antigens, these are the foreign substance or molecules that can produce antibodies or activates our immune system. These antigens, these may be proteins, these may be carbohydrates, these may be lipids, and these may be the cell wall of bacteria, or you can say viruses, etc. Alright, so all the foreign substances that are recognized as non-cell by our immune system and that can activate our immune system, that can produce antibodies, that type of substances or molecules are called antigens. Antigens are also known as agglutinogen. They are also known as agglutinogen. Now, when these antigen, we can write the symbol of antigen as Ag. When these antigen come in contact with our B cells, or you can say B lymphocytes. B lymphocytes are specifically, you can say, their origin and their development undergoes in bone marrow. That's why they are called B lymphocytes, that plays very important role in humoral immune system. So when antigens come in contact with our B cells or B lymphocytes, it will form two types of cells, memory cells, and they will form special plasma cells. These plasma cells, these forms antibodies. These form antibodies. These are also called agglutinogen. We have marked this antigen as agglutinogen. This is agglutin. Alright students. So this plasma cell, they generally generate 2000 to 20,000 of antibodies per second, you can say, after the, you can say, encounter of, yeah, after the entry of antigen in the body. So if we talk about what is antibodies, so we are here to discuss antibodies. Students, these are specifically glycoproteins or immunoglobulins that helps to fight against antigens. So antibodies are also represented as AB. These antibodies are specifically immunoglobulins. Immunoglobulins that are also called IG. And these are also called agglutinin. Alright students, these are specifically glycoproteins. So अप टू दिस टॉपिक वी हैव क्लियर दैट व्हेनेवर द फॉरेन पार्टिकल एंटर्स इन अवर बॉडी अवर बी लिम्फोसाइट्स कम इन दैट कॉन्टैक्ट इट फॉर्म मेमोरी सेल्स फॉर फर्दर एक्सपोजर एंड इट फॉर्म प्लाज्मा सेल्स दैट गिव राइज टू एंटीबॉडीज दीज एंटीबॉडीज मे बी ऑफ डिफरेंट टाइप्स दैट मे बी ऑफ IgA, IgD, IgG, IgM, IgE. IgM and IgE, alright. IgE, alright. So these are different types of antibodies that are produced by plasma cells. So now, what is these antibodies are very specific to their antigens. How they are specific to their antigens? Actually, like the lock and key concept, similarly, antibodies also have a specific place where antigen comes and bind. Similarly, on antigen surface, there is a specific site on which antibody binds. So if we talk about antigen, so the site, suppose this is the antigen. And here is the specific site where antibody binds. So this is called epitope. This is called epitope. And if we talk about antibodies, they are having a Y-shaped structure. And these are, here is the antigen binding site. These are called paratopes. Alright, these are called paratopes, very very important. Epitopes, they are the antibody binding sites on antigen. Paratopes are the antigen binding sites present on antibodies. Alright, so what is the antigen and antibody interaction cause, or is called as antigen antibody reaction, is called as agglutination. This is called agglutination, as the clumping or precipitation occurs when antigen and antibody reacts together. This is called agglutination. This process is called, reaction process is called agglutination, students. And the study of antigen-antibody interaction is called serology. This is called serology. So now we have done what is antigen, what are antibodies. Now we are coming to the types of antibodies. So there are different types of antibodies like IgA, IgG, IgM, IgE, IgD. So now we are coming to types of antibodies. Types of antibodies. These are specifically of this type IgA, IgD, IgG, IgE. IgM you can say, and then IgE. Alright, so before doing the difference between these types of antibodies, first of all we will discuss the basic structure of antibody. Alright, structure of antibody. So there is a specifically Y-shaped structure in antibodies that is made up of two heavy chains and two light chains. This is heavy chain, you can say. First heavy chain. This is second heavy chain. And light chains are present here. As these are specifically glycoproteins, or you can say proteins, so there is two terminals, N-terminal and C-terminal. This is N-terminal, this is C-terminal. Similarly in light chain, N-terminal, C-terminal. alright? Like in every polypeptide or proteins have two terminals. So if we talk about, this is the light chain, this is light chain, this is heavy chain. Similarly, this is light chain and this is heavy chain. Alright students, these light chain and heavy chains are having disulfide bonds between them. They are having disulfide bonds between them. That maintains the structure of antibodies. Students, this is specifically this region having antigen binding site. This is antigen binding site on the both side. Antigen binding site. This is antigen binding site. As we have done, this is also called paratope. Alright? These are present on antibodies. Now, in antibody structure, some region is variable and some region is constant. So, if we talk about this heavy chain, this region is constant region that I am marking dark. This is the constant region that have a constant structure, or you can say constant sequence of amino acids. This is the variable region. This is variable region of heavy chain. This is variable region of light chain. So, this is the basic structure of antibody. Now, we will come to different types of antibodies. That is IgA. This is also called secretory antibody. Why this is called secretory antibody? Because it is present in all body secretion. It is present in body secretions like sweat, tears, saliva, mucus, etc. Alright student, it is also present in colostrum, very important. Student, what is colostrum? Sometime it asks in CBSE as well as in NEET. This is the initial yellow colored fluid. Initial golden, you can say, or yellow colored fluid released from mammary glands just after the delivery, or you can say 2-3 days after delivery. Whenever the initial fluid comes before the milk secretion occurs, this is that liquid is called colostrum, and that is rich in IgA. That's why it is said that mother milk is very important for infants up to 6 months. So, up to 6 months breastfeeding is suggested. Next, we will come to IgD. This is present in a low amount. You can say present only on surface of B cells. B lymphocytes, you can say. This IgG, this can transfer through. This is most abundant student, 80 to 85% you can say of the total antibodies, and this is around 8 to 10%. This is again of, you can say, 10%, and this is less than 1%, you can. Less than 1%. This IgE also less than 1%. Less than 1%. Alright. And if we talk about IgA, so this is 10 to 15%. Alright, this is the basic, you can say, percentage. So we are here, IgG, this can transfer through, placenta from mother to fetus. Alright, this IgM, this plays very important role. You can say it is the first antibody that formed after infection. First antibody formed after infection, you can say, or entry of antigen. Entry of antigen. This IgE, this is mainly responsible in allergic reactions, you can say, and this is also associated with basophils and mast cells that release histamine, you can say. So if we talk about the structure of these antibodies, so specifically this IgA, if we talk about IgA, this is dimeric in nature, means two Y-shaped structure are joined together with the help of J chain. So this IgA is dimeric, having two molecules, or you can say how many antigen binding sites are there, how many paratopes are there? Paratopes in IgAR4. Alright. So again we are going to discuss the structure of IgG or IgD, you can say. So they are having a single Y-shaped molecule and that have only two paratopes, and only one Y-shaped structure is included, or antibody. So this is called monomeric in nature and having two. Most important for NEET is this IgM, and if you talk about structure, this IgA is also important for NEET. If you talk about the structure of IgM, this is pentameric in nature. Students, keep in your mind, this is pentameric in nature. It have five Y-shaped structures that are joined together with the help of J chain, you can say. And how many paratopes will be there if five Y-shaped structures are there? So total 10 paratopes will be there. Total 10 paratopes, antigen binding sites. This is the region why this IgM formed first after the entry of antigen, and if there is any infection, why IgE formed first. Alright students, so today we have discussed what are antigens, what are antibodies, and what is the specific structures of these antibodies. If we talk about what are the reactions of antigen and antibodies called, this is called agglutination, we have already discussed. But the if we talk about different types of reaction when antigen and antibody interaction take place, so it may be as we have discussed, agglutination, or you can say precipitation, that may be neutralization. That may be lysis, that may be opsonization. Let me tell you something about this. We have already discussed agglutination. As antigens are soluble molecules, so whenever they combine with antigen, they form a heavy particle or heavy structure, you can say, and that is insoluble, you can say, structure, that is called agglutination, or the precipitate form is called precipitation. If we talk about neutralization, so this antibody covers the, you can say, virulent region, or you can say virulent regions of bacteria, or you can say, so that's why they can convert the virulent into non-virulent one. That's why it is called neutralization. Virulent antigens or bacteria into non-virulent by covering their virulent sites, by covering their toxic sites, you can say. If we talk about lysis, so whenever these antibodies sometime attach on the surface of bacteria or any other antigen, so they can cause the lysis of cell. This reaction is called lysis. If we talk about opsonization, so these antibodies, they sometimes form a complex. Because antibodies are also called opsins. So whenever they combine with antigens and they forms a complex, that reaction is called opsonization. So students, in this lecture we have discussed what are antigen, what are antibodies, distress structures of antibodies, and then different reactions between antigen and antibody. Hope you have cleared the topic of antigen and antibody. In our next video, we will discuss about more concepts of immunology. Till then, stay tuned. Goodbye.